Hello everyone. So now we'll focus on Laravel connectivity with various kinds of database, how we fetch records, how we insert records and manipulate records inside the database. So first of all, I would like to tell you that Laravel has everything done with supporting with the following type of the databases. Like I would like to mention MySQL, PostgreSQL, SQLite, SQL Server. It has the processing with the database very easy. The query to the database can be fired using raw SQL, Query Builder or ORM. The configuration is, I'll show you in our project, the configuration is done inside config database.php. So I would open this file. So this is my file. It gives me the various type of the configurations for different type of the databases, for SQLite, for MySQL, for PostgreSQL, that is PG, SQL, and so on. And it has various kinds of cluster indexes and various dependencies. Now we will focus on one thing. We'll create a database inside our localhost, or I can say localhost PHP MyAdmin, that is MySQL, and over there we will insert records in it. So let's try doing it now. So before creating our SQL thing, I would open our XAMPP server or WAMP, whatever is there in your system. I'll open my WAMP server, and inside localhost MyAdmin, I would create a database name test. So here it shows that Laravel supports dependencies with the MySQL stuff. So here I will create a database. There's no password associated with it. I'll create a new database name test. The database is created. Over here I'll create a table, and the table will be student and columns will be 2. So first is ID. Second is name. ID will be the primary key. So I'll specify ID as the primary key. And name will be varchar with 50 length. 50 will be fine. Save it. So I've created a database inside test, a table name student. Now we'll focus on how to add, delete, update, retrieve records from the database using Laravel. So first is to insert records inside it. So before inserting records, we need to understand the syntax, like how the inserting of the records takes place in Laravel. So as we have seen, like different type of database structure which supported by Laravel, now we will focus on what will be the basic syntax for insertion of the records. After that, we'll focus on creating views, models and controllers associated with it, and then we can check how insertion takes place for this table, that is student table. The structure is ID and name. So let's focus on that. So I'll show you in my presentation. It's here. Creation of the table has been done. We have created ID and name. Now insert records. The syntax for insert records is mentioned over here. Boolean insert string, and here I mentioned the query. And array bindings. What are array bindings? That are values to bind with the queries. The most important thing, the syntax of this is Boolean. So it returns a Boolean value that is true or false. It will return true if the insertion has been done successfully. It will return false if the insertion was not done successfully. Now, this is usually done to run an insert statement against the database. Let's check out with our database. So I'm moving on to our code. Before that, I will create inside the command prompt. I will check out, like, I'll create a new command prompt, and over there I will first of all create a controller. So let's moving on to our desktop. Here it is. Here I will create a new command prompt. I'll mention it as run as administrator. Okay. Inside our project, sample project, I will run this following command. It is simple. I have mentioned this in the earlier chapters. PHP artisan make controller student update controller, okay, or sorry, student insert, I think updation is not done, so it is student insert controller. Some spelling mistake would have been mentioned. Okay, there is two colons in it. I made a mistake over there. Okay, the controller has been created successfully. Now the other thing which you need to do now is to make some kind of changes inside this controller. So let's check it. So we'll move on to our project. Inside project, that is sample project app HTTP controllers. So here it is, student insert controller. Okay, for now I'll keep close all other files which are not required. We'll associate only with the database files and the respective controllers views and models. Okay, so now only database.php is there, and now student insert controller is there. Here I'll create a function. The function name will be public function, and the function name is insert form. Okay, so I've created a function. This is used typically for inserting data. Okay, always better practice to mention comments before writing down the functions. Now here I will say it will return a view. For now we have not created a view, we'll create it right now, not a problem. Return view std create. Okay, this view will interact with the users, so this is for redirecting to the particular view. Now I'll create another function, public function insert. Okay, here I'll say request, and one parameter will be there, that is dollar request. We have gone through what is request in the previous chapters, how it is implemented. So I have request parameter included in it, and here I'll say dollar name, that is to take the name from the user, that is dollar underscore request input